Greetings, my friends. Brother Joey here. I wanted to do a quick update on some of the latest developments going on in the Israel-Palestinian conflict, if you will, and things are constantly heating up in that regard as well. And recently, as this piece here that I've got pulled up on the screen alludes to, there was a Mideast Peace Conference held back on January the 15th, which representatives of more than 70 nations in international organizations came out, and they affirmed, according to their agreements, that a two-state solution is the only viable option for peace. And of course, many people believe that, according to Bible prophecy over there in Daniel chapter 9, they believe that the Antichrist, the end-time one-world leader, will sign a seven-year peace treaty. And so many believe this is laying the groundwork for that to take place. And we're going to talk about that in depth in videos to come. But I want to give you an update on the situation over there on some of the latest developments, starting with this. And then on the heels of this, Israel came out and approved the construction of 2,500 housing units in the Jewish settlements in the West Bank area. This happened just on Tuesday. Just 2 days after Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu spoke with newly elected United States President Donald Trump. And speaking of Trump, we know that recently he came out and he's been pushing to move the U.S. embassy that's currently located down in Tel Aviv, and he wants to move it to Jerusalem. And so this has created a big outcry from many people, especially the Palestinians, who've recently, as this piece alludes to here, came out and established a Palestinian embassy in the Vatican. As it goes on to read here, the Palestinian Authority on Saturday inaugurated an embassy in the Vatican. And the Palestinian-based Ma'an News Agency reported on Friday. Goes on to mention here that it was announced earlier in the week that Pope Francis would grant Abbas an audience at the Vatican on Saturday, marking the third time that the Pope has met with Abbas, and the Pope has become more involved in this whole process, which is also, consistent with Bible prophecy, and that's something I'm going to do a specific video on very soon. But that's not all they've been up to. The Palestinians have also appealed to Russia, as this article alludes to help stop this potential U.S. embassy relocation, as the Palestinian Authority has asked Russia to intervene and stop the United States from likely relocating its embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem under President Donald Trump. And it goes on to say that Saeb Erekat, the head of the Palestine Liberation Organization and chief Palestinian negotiator with the Israelis, has traveled to Russia on a mission to deliver a written message from Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas to the Russian government. And apparently it is asking President Putin and Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov's intervention in order to sit with the American administration to prevent the American embassy move to Jerusalem. And this is another significant piece of news for this particular reason, because we know Russia is a key player in end-time prophecy. And we know that according to the Battle of Gog and Magog and other end-time apocalyptic war prophecies, that Russia will at some point invade the Holy Land. Okay? And so I believe we're seeing the groundwork and the foreshadowing of many other Bible prophecies that are going to come to pass here in the near future. And, we talk about many others that are already in motion. And as those other prophecies, such as, the Isaiah 17 and Jeremiah 49 prophecies on the destruction of Damascus, continue to play out over there in Syria, it's only going to open the door for more of God's word to continue to come alive in these world events, as Bible prophecy continues to motion towards literal fulfillment, as we watch these world powers align in ways that are consistent with what God's holy word says. And in fact, in more news here from the Israel National News Arutz Shiva Network, we see that according to the Fatah leader, Palestine must be liberated through fighting, he says. And it goes on to say here, the West continuously says that Palestinian Authority Chairman Mahmoud Abbas's Fatah faction is moderate and a peace partner for Israel, as opposed to its rival Hamas, whose constitution calls for Israel's destruction. However, a video recently released, and I'll link this up in the description box below, by the Middle East Media Research Institute, proves yet again that Fatah is just as willing as Hamas is to resort to violence against Israel. And it's really symbolic of what the Bible says will come in the last days, this false peace, and how there will be a one-world Antichrist leader that will destroy many by this false peace. And, you know, just look around the world today, and we're certainly seeing much war being waged, if you will, in the name of humanitarian efforts and peace, when in fact it couldn't be further from the truth. And, you know, staying on the topic of Mahmoud Abbas, one of his aides was quoted recently as saying in this report here from Israel National News that moving the American embassy is a declaration of war. And it says here, Mahmoud Al-Habash, senior advisor to Palestinian chairman, warns Donald Trump in a sermon not to move the American embassy to Jerusalem. And there's a quote here saying, such a step for every Muslim is the declaration of war on all Muslims. You know, and so we see earlier, the article previous to this one here, that they're calling that Palestine must be liberated through fighting. Now we see them claiming that moving the American embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem is a declaration of war on all Muslims. Meanwhile, powerful Shiite cleric has joined the chorus of Arab leaders warning of violent backlash if the United States transfers the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. In this piece here from the Times of Israel, as the headline reads, Iraq's al-Sadir threatens to liberate Jerusalem if Trump moves embassy. And again, it references how, you know, the Abbas aide recently said that moving the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem would be a declaration of war against Islam. So we're seeing this thing ramp up and, you know, certainly foreshadowing the eventual steady but slow progression towards a Bible prophecy regarding Israel. And so on the heels of all this war rhetoric and saber rattling here, we see that Israeli Defense Minister Lieberman came out and said, in the next war, Israel Defense Forces won't stop until the enemy raises the white flag in what is just more evidence of the intensifying conflict over there. And as it says here, the defense minister actually came out and he mocked world powers in their ineffectual meddling in international conflicts, including over there in Syria, saying they would be better advised not to interfere in the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And eventually, we're going to see, I believe, and because that's what the Bible says. The Bible says that regional conflict will intensify over in the Middle East, ultimately leading to Armageddon, with Jerusalem being the focal point. You know, when we find that in scriptures like Zechariah 14 and, you know, and other scriptures, of course. But this climactic end time battle referred to as Armageddon is also called the battle of that great day of God Almighty in Revelation 16:14. And so we're seeing everything foreshadow and slowly culminate to the climax of what is going to be a focal point over there in Jerusalem. So all these other conflicts are only working up to that ultimate end where God gathers the nations around Israel, as it says there in Zechariah 14, and then fights against them. And, you know, I'll be doing definitely an extensive video on that in my End Time Prophecy series that I'm going to release, hopefully starting next month, Lord willing. Anyhow, I'll link you guys up with everything that I showed you here in the description box below, as usual. But some important developments going on over there in the Holy Land and between the Palestinians and the Israelis. And you know, Palestine, they came out, they established an embassy in the Vatican. They are seeking help from Russia to stop this U.S. embassy relocation. We've seen the calls from Arab leaders threatening violence against Israel. The Abbas aide came out and said that moving the U.S. embassy is a declaration of war against Islam. So we can see if things continue along this line, which God's holy word says they will, that it's headed nowhere good. And my friends, I just pray that you're right with the Lord, that you've given your life to Jesus Christ, and that you're born again and you've repented of your sin. Because unless you're born again, as Jesus said in John 3, you will not see the kingdom of heaven. So I'm going to finish there. This is Brother Joey signing out. God bless you all in Jesus' mighty name. Some of the latest developments, starting with this. And then on the heels of this, Israel came out and approved the construction of 2,500 housing units in the Jewish settlements in the West Bank area. This happened just on Tuesday, just 2 days after Prime Minister came out, and they affirmed, according to their agreements, that a two-state solution is the only viable option for peace. And of course, many people believe that, according to Bible prophecy, over there in Daniel chapter 9, they believe that the Antichrist, the end-time one-world leader, will sign a 7-year peace treaty. And so many believe this is laying the groundwork for that to take place. And we're going to talk about that in depth in videos to come. But I want to give you an update on the situation over there. And some are constantly heating up in that regard as well. And recently, as this piece here that I've got pulled up on the screen alludes to, there was a Mideast peace conference held back on January the 15th, which representatives of more than 70 nations and international organizations. Greetings, my friends. Brother Joey here. I wanted to do a quick update on some of the latest developments going on in the Israel-Palestinian conflict, if you will, and things.